Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian, and today we're going to take a look at the question of what was the first automatic pistol. Now, anytime you look at any question of what was the first blank, the answers are going to get kind of fractal, in that the more detailed you get, and the closer you look, and the more you study, the grayer everything gets, because you get more and more questions, and things become less clear. So, for example, the first commercially successful semi-auto pistol is universally considered to be the C93 Borchardt. About 3,000 were made, first introduced in 1893. There's really no doubt about that. But what if you want to consider, well, maybe what about guns that weren't commercially successful? Because there were a selection of them. The closer you look, now you have to start considering, what are your standards? Does this need to be a gun that was put into serial production? Maybe one that was offered for commercial sale but wasn't sold in substantial numbers? In which case the question is, what numbers are considered substantial? Would you consider a gun that was submitted to military trials and did decently or did badly? Or what about a gun that wasn't submitted? And ultimately, you can get all the way down to this very granular level of, well, this guy handmade this thing that was allegedly semi-auto. Does that count? Now, so if you ask me what is the first automatic pistol, not necessarily commercially successful, just the first one that was built, I'm going to ignore handmade one-off prototypes, because ultimately there's no way to really track down all of them and figure out whose was the first, and then there really is a question of, does this thing really actually work? Maybe it was luck. Maybe your idea was good, but your prototype was bad. There are a lot of variables there. I would much rather look at ones, set the standard at making 5 or 10 of them in series, like to the point they have serial numbers on them. I think that's a pretty decent standard. And maybe they didn't pass military trials or sell commercially, and I wouldn't necessarily expect that, because the very early guns, even if they work right, they're going to be complex, they're going to be heavy, they're going to be expensive, because they are really bleeding-edge technology. So I don't expect the first one to have been commercially or militarily successful. I just want to know if it actually worked. Now, when we get to that level, we end up with two main competitors for the title of first automatic pistol. One of them is the Salvatore Dormus, and the other is the Schonberger-Laumann. Now, it's actually, or at least that's what you would generally read. In actual fact, it's not the Schonberger-Laumann, it's just the Laumann. We have two of the Schonberger-Laumanns right here, and they're actually a pistol that comes a couple years later. The Schonberger-Laumann is an 1894 gun. So, actually, these Schonberger-Laumanns are after the Borchardt. Now, we have a Dormus pistol here, a Salvatore Dormus. That particular gun was made in 1896. It's not the first iteration of the Salvatore Dormus, but when we look at what was the first, Salvatore Dormus remains one of our legit contenders, and the other is the Laumann automatic pistol. Now, unfortunately, I don't have a Laumann here to show you, but I do have some pictures of one. What we have here is a Laumann manually repeating pistol, because before we had semi-autos, we had manual ring trigger activated repeating pistols. The first of which, the kind of iconic one that people don't usually associate with this sort of stuff, is the Volcanic, which was invented back in the 1850s. Now in Austria, people in the late 1870s into the 1880s were building these sorts of manual repeating pistols, generally activated by ring triggers, and those are the guns that developed into semi-autos. People realized that, hey, you know, if we turn this into like a blowback action, this manual pistol can become a self-loading pistol. And that's pretty much what happened with the Laumann here. This is a manual Laumann dating to 1888, and by 1891, Laumann had filed a patent for a semi-auto version of his gun. Now, within a couple years of that, 1892, his gun was actually built. By 1894, he was working with Schonberger, and they were making improved versions, which are these. So, the patent date on the semi-auto Laumann is November 25th, 1891, and that's an Austrian patent filed in Vienna. I'm going with Austrian patents here because that's where these inventors were pretty much all located, and that would have been the first place that they patented their guns. You'll find these patents in other countries, like the United States, typically with later patent dates, because either they were filed later, after the fact, or they just took a long time to process through. You have to be careful to look at patent application dates, not patent granting dates in this case. So, November 25, 1891 is our current contender, that's the Laumann. However, if we start looking at Dormus patents, what we find is that the Salvatore Dormus was also patented in 1891. It was also patented in November 1891. It was in fact patented on November 21st, 1891. So, as I see it, the title of first automatic pistol goes to the Salvatore Dormus by 4 days. Really pretty cool. It was that close to the wire. What this practically means is that there were a bunch of guys in Vienna and in Austria who were working pretty hard on this problem of self-loading pistols. That was really the nexus of development of early semi-autos. Some into Germany as well, but primarily in Austria. Oh. If you're interested in this subject in more depth, I would strongly recommend purchasing this book by Motz and Schui. It is in German only, and it is an expensive book, but it is a fantastically detailed book that will get into all sorts of minutiae about not just the early semi-auto pistols, also some of the later semi-auto pistols that were actually well developed, and a bunch of information on some of these manual pistols, like this Laumann and this Bittner. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. I think we have an interesting take here, being able to actually look at all of these examples. We'll be doing some videos on these guns individually and independently to get a closer look at them. So make sure to tune back in for that. And if you really enjoy this sort of content and would like to help support the channel, please consider dropping in on my Patreon page and signing up there to help support. That's really what allows me to travel about and find guns like these to make videos for you guys. Thanks for watching.